We're currently going back to Loki and following up that mineralization and seeing if we can find if there's, a much larger system and some of the holes too, so we have that mineralization at the unconformity now, but the holes themselves have alteration that's never been seen as well. So basically that the whole sandstone column is bleached white. It's full of faults and so it's the most exciting thing that we've ever seen in this part of the world for sure.
All right, welcome back inside our proactive newsroom. And joining me now is Rebecca Hunter. She is the CEO of Baselode Energy Corp. And Rebecca, it's good to see you. How are you?
Very good, and it's great to see you, Steve.
So exciting news out from the company yesterday in regards to your Aberdeen project in Nunavut, and more specifically at one particular area of that project. I'll let you take it from there because this is really unique stuff that we're talking about.
Yeah, so it's exciting to get some news out on our project here. So we've been drilling now for about a month and a half, and so the press release is really highlighting our Loki target. And so, this year we've done a lot of kind of blue sky targeting, and Loki is like one of our main ones. So it's a really large gravity anomaly. So that's basically one of the ways we hone into these deposits geophysically. And so it's about a 4 kilometer by 1 kilometer long kind of trend that we're exploring, and we've got a couple holes into it, historically, and then last year showed some exciting results. We wanted to go back, so it showed some of that, bleaching and clay and the stuff that we look for these type of unconformity deposits. And so we went back this year. And so, what's really encouraging, what's really exciting is that we had 5 holes so far, 4 of which have really good alteration, and one of which has mineralization, weak mineralization at the unconformity. And so this is a first for the Northeast Thelon project or area. So it's not just our project, but this is the first time that actual uranium mineralization has been intersected at the unconformity in the sandstone. And so that's pretty key.
Yeah, and Rebecca, in the news release, you talk about the sort of relation to the Athabasca Basin, which we see a lot of this. This is now the first time you've seen it in this particular area, and I would imagine that's exciting for project in general when you're starting to see something that has some similarities to an area that has become quite famous around the world.
Exactly. So in the Athabasca Basin, prolific, you have these unconformity deposits at the unconformity. And in the Thelon to date, all the mineralization is basement-hosted. And so that's why this is a bit of a game changer. And it's something that I'm, on this base load, we want to really find is these type of deposits at the unconformity. And at Loki, we now have evidence that it exists.
So how do you move forward now? Obviously this is a big one, so you want to sort of try getting as much more information you can about that. Are you now going to stick to specifically where that hole was, or what's sort of the plan moving forward with the drill program?
Yeah, so our drill program, we are testing in numerous trends, but yeah, we're currently going back to Loki and following up that mineralization and seeing if we can find if there's, a much larger system and some of the holes too, so we have that mineralization at the unconformity now, but the holes themselves have alteration that's never been seen as well. So basically that the whole sandstone column is bleached white. It's full of faults, and so it's the most exciting thing that we've ever seen in this part of the world, for sure.
And lastly, Rebecca, obviously with the Athabasca Basin, the where it is, it's a lot of talk about it as far as North American supply of uranium. Where you are right now, it really opens up a bigger market, let's say, for overseas as well. Is that you're getting those types of questions from people off news like this?
Yeah, well, I certainly getting questions, but I think that's our big driver here is for, baseload, and then the new company will become Geiger. Our focus is to find another uranium district, and we think it's going to be the Thelon Basin.
All right, we'll leave it there, Rebecca. Thanks so much for the update. Really appreciate it. Good to talk to you, and we'll talk again soon, okay?
Thanks a lot.
All right, Rebecca Hunter, the CEO of Baselode Energy Corp.